Dear Mr. Rector, dear Mr. Vice Rector, dear professors, dear guests, dear students, it's my great pleasure to have a, let's say, brief presentation about the topics related with forest and the intersection between forest, trees, and human health. I want to apologize for my voice. It's due to the fact that my small child is going to the kindergarten and he's bringing a present home. Viruses, but I want to point out that I'm COVID-free, so everything is okay. Good. So I want also to give a special thanks to Mr. Vice Rector Stanica, who invited me and gave me the chance to introduce also the forest in this conference, because within the Faculty of Agriculture, we are studying also forestry from 2004, and we are conducting also research related with forestry. My main field of interest is the one that is using trees for land reclamation. And let's say something about forest products and other related topics. So, my presentation will be focusing on mainly three topics. I will give you a short introduction regarding the facts and figures at worldwide level regarding the forest. After that, I will speak about the importance of urban trees and green areas. And in the end, I will connect this information and data with the concept of human health and, let's say, the benefits related with forest, urban trees, and human health. I'm looking now in the room, and I saw also some other participants on the Zoom meeting, and I'm quite sure that when I'm telling about forest, every one of you have a different image or a different idea. This is normal, since at worldwide level we are speaking about more than 800 definitions for the forest. One of the most common used one is the one provided by FAO, Food and Agriculture Organization, according to which a forest is a land which has at least 0.5 hectares and a canopy cover of more than 10%, and it's not primarily used for agriculture or other urban land uses. In the two pictures, on the right-hand image, you will see a Dehesa forest, a typical forest for Spain, and on the left-hand side, there is a mixed forest from Romanian Carpathians, the one that is typical for that region and the most common for our country. So it's quite a little bit different, as you can observe. Regarding the main facts and figures of the forest at worldwide level. As you may know, about one third of the global land area is covered with forest. That means that we have a little bit more than 4 billion hectares of forest worldwide. That means that every one of us could have a forest larger, like a football stadium, so 0.5 hectares. Worldwide, there are around 60,000 tree species, and almost half of them are grouped in only 10 families. But as regards their distributions, it's good to know that half of the worldwide forests are concentrated, are found in only 5 countries, and 2/3 of the forests are found in 10 countries. This is the most recent published data from the Food and Agriculture Organization in the so-called State of the World's Forest Report that was published last year. I mentioned that half of the forests are located in 5 countries. These are the Russian Federation, of course, Brazil, Canada, United States of America, and China. And the rest 5, so in total 2/3 of worldwide forests are found in 10 countries. As a matter of fact, for example, Romania has 7 million So 7 million hectares out of the 4 billion hectares of worldwide forest. Of course, there is a big, let's say, diversity as regards the percentage of the forest at country level. For example, there are several countries with a large area of forest, French Guinea, for example, Suriname or Micronesia, but there are also some countries with no forest at all, like Qatar, Monaco, and San Marino. I'll continue with introducing this, citing the director of FAO Forestry Divisions. According to this director, forests provide goods and services, employment and income to perhaps 2.5 billion people worldwide. So at worldwide level, the forest sector is a very important one from several points of view, including providing products and services that are very connected to human health. So, as regards human health, I had the curiosity to search for, most cited articles on Google Academic, and in total I found that around 2.7 million scientific papers published in the field of forest and human health. Most of them are very recent, in the last 10 to 20 years. In general, we know that forests have a positive impact in several fields, like on air quality through deposing the pollens, so by taking the pollens from the air and purifying the air, reducing the summertime air temperature, and I will give you an example for Romania in the following slides, and decrease, why not, the ultraviolet radiation that is harmful in an extent, specific extent. Also, forests provide the recreational, cultural, spiritual, and aesthetical services. And now, if you would think about all of these, services, all of them are connected with human health. And I will provide you specific examples. When we are going into the forest, when we are visiting the forest, our stress level is going down. This is the main achievement of a forest visit. In the same time, we are recovering from the attention fatigue, or the forest strongly enhance both physiological and physical rehabilitation. And why not? Several scientific papers, according to several scientific research, it is stated nowadays that the forest visits are curing the so-called modern diseases such as burnout and depression. I guess that at the end of this year, most of us are almost burnout, so it's why not recommended to go to have a visit in the forest. I tried to, concentrate the main figures related with forest visits and human health, and the main ideas consist in. So, when we are going into a forest, the blood pressure is reducing, the alleviative negative emotions, the blood cortisol also is decreasing, also the intensive immune and the immune function is intensifying, and the mental health is also improving. So these are perhaps the main relations between the forest visits and the human health. I searched for specific examples, and I found many of them in also very recently published paper by food and agriculture organizations. For example, in Germany, they use using the forests for human health by construction these specific facilities. And I'll give you an example for Romania. I guess you know that the people who are suffering from lungs, they have lung problems, is recommended to go in a pine forest due to the specific nuance and other useful things produced at those pine forests. Another example is from Japan. So Japan is paying very much attention to the food that is originating from the forest, and also most of the instructions are made within the forest ecosystems. So they call the forest therapy, a very strong concept in Japan. Also, another country from Asia, Republic of Korea, they are paying more attention to the forest policy and forest healing. So, as you can see, a lot of roads and alleys are managed in this forest, and they are designated for forest business, to spend as much as possible in the forest, to have several activities, recreational activities within the forest. But forest is not only trees, or in the forest, except wood, we will find several non-wood forest products. Both categories are very important in the relation with human health, and I will provide you some examples. The first one is from a paper recently published in the International Journal of Environmental Research and Public Health. So the researchers tried to assess the wood and its impacts on humans and environmental quality in a healthcare facility from Slovak Republic. So they, in a waiting room at the National Oncology Institute, they reconstructed it. They introduced more wood, and the patients spent their time in this new reconstructed room, which is mainly made by wood. So they did specific experiments with specific, electrocardiography holters. So things related also with medicine, not others. And the main conclusions of this research consist in the fact that the brain is under less stress when we are spending more time in a room which is made mainly by wood, in comparison with a room where the furniture is made by plastic, glass, or other materials. Of course, there are several other results. One funny one, is the wow effect of the wood on humans. This is how the Slovak researchers call it, this effect. Another example, this time a review paper, physiological effects of wood on humans. The main idea is that it is considered that the human body is adapted to a natural setting due to the fact that during our 7 million years of evolution, 99.99% we spend it in a natural environment, so we have this, natural environments in our DNA. And according to this study, the main results of this study said that the olfactory, visual, tactile, and auditory simulation involving wood-derived material introduce physiological relaxation, such as reduction of brain activities, and so on. So another, very cited article saying that the wood is very important to our health, to our daily life, and pointing out the main benefits from the human health perspectives. Another example related with the wood, this one is from what's published last year, also by the Food and Agriculture Organization of the United Nations, Forest for Human Health and Well-Being. It's not the case in Bucharest, but it's the case that over 75% of rural households in low and medium income communities that are using wood fuel for cooking. And there is a strong relation between using wood fuel for cooking and human health. The main explanation consists in the fact that cooking is necessary for the utilization of many foods as well as for boiling and sterilizing water. 75% of the rural households in low and medium income countries. So once again, the wood is very important for human healthcare. This is the graph on the continent level. So the main problem, of course, is in Africa, but also in many countries across Asia and Oceania, and also in Latin America, Caribbeans. So as you can see, the data is from 2017, so it's quite recent. Another two concrete examples, this time forest or wood as a source of bioactive compounds and drugs. Two examples, taxol, the bioactive compound originated from the bark of Taxus, Taxus baccata, the main species, actually the only one species of Romania, for example, is used as a drug for breast or ovarian cancer and has been called one of the best anti-cancer agents developed from natural products. And the second one, quite interesting, the nuts from Norway spruce, which are obvious, are rich in a hydroxymethyl sinol, which has strong antioxidative as well as potential anti-tumor properties. How about the nanwood forest products? It's a very, there are several categories across Romania, across Europe, and also across the world, but in most of the cases we found mushrooms, edible and poisonous mushrooms, so we have to be very careful when we are collecting mushrooms, because it is well known that many wild mushrooms are toxic, only a few species are edible. Again, there is a large body of scientific papers published in recent years regarding the poisonous mushrooms in English and other international language, at least 50,000 papers published in the last 10 years that are dealing with the subject poisonous mushrooms. I will try to introduce in my presentation both the things that are good, coming from the forest as regard to the human health, but also the things that are not so good, also originating from forest ecosystems, like the case of the edible mushrooms. I will try to have a balanced presentations, so we will see also good examples, but also bad examples that should be avoided in order to be healthy. There is also on Wikipedia a list of deadly fungus species. I am not trusting very well this, website, so I recommend you to have additional information, data sets, databases, academic and one in special. Another nanwood forest products category is the one where we find several forest fruits or berries, wild berries, several other names at worldwide level. A big amount of wild berries also in our country. Most of the people that are living in the rural area are collecting them during the late summer or autumn and consuming them as raw or prepared in different types. Again, a big amount of scientific papers published regarding the forest food, the using of forest food for human health, more almost 50 million papers published in the last 20 years. The forest fruits are important from several perspectives. The one is that they contain several bioactivities and several elements, vitamins that are, very useful for human health. As you can see from this chart, it's also originating from the FAO published paper last year, a very relevant one in this domain. Another category consists of medicinal plants. According to FAO, there are 28,000 plant species that are used for medicinal purposes, and most of them are located in the forest, in the forest ecosystems. Several examples. I will give you one example from one of my friends who, with 200 euros, constructed this natural drying system for plants, herbal plants, and it's very useful using sun energy, so it's cost effective and it's a good investment. According to World Health Organization, 80% of the global population still relies on botanical drugs, so the medicinal plants are playing a very important role from this perspective. Not too common in our country, but quite common in other countries like Canada, for example, the tree saps, of course, from maples, usually extracting from maple species, but we can extract it from birch, and I did an experiment with one of my students. We managed to collect 80 liters in 8 hours from 35 trees, so the productivity was a good one. The tree sap is also important because it has a high concentration, of course, of sugar, but also of calcium, magnesium, carbohydrates, vitamin C, and several vitamins from the complex and other important components. Forest insects, not so much studied from the perspective of non-wood forest products in our country, but in other countries, especially across Asia, they are very important because they are creating several damages or several injuries to humans, but as you will see in the following slides, they are also used in nutrition. So, as regards the main classification, let's say, criteria, we are speaking about biting species, stinging species, or species covered with protective or venomous hairs, and I will give you only a few examples because there are too many examples. As regards the blood feeding insects, we are speaking about mosquitoes, black flies, and tabanids. And as you may know, mosquitoes are the main vectors for malaria, and according again to World Health Organization in 2017, malaria was estimated to affect more than 200 million people, with almost 500,000 deaths. So it still is a very important disease that we have to treat it. As regards the stinging insects, the wasps perhaps are the, let's say, the best examples, because if you are not so lucky and you will be stinged by 20 to 200 wasps or 150 to 1,000 honeybees, you have the chance to have to record a renal failure or even death. So we have to be very careful regarding these insects that are very often found in the forest ecosystems. And another example regarding the insects covered with venomous fur, Dredolimus pini. So it can cause chronic osteoporosis or rarely scleritis. So several diseases caused by several insects, and perhaps the most common out of these four examples are the ticks. So the ones that are causing the Lyme diseases is not too common in Romania, but USA it is cited that every year almost 500,000 new diseases are recorded. I remember that in 2009 I had the chance to meet some ticks, and I went directly to the hospital, and the doctors were not very aware of these Lyme diseases. But nowadays, for example, in Bucharest, we have a specific institute that is treating the Lyme diseases, because it's a very, let's say, unpredictable disease. So, in 80 countries across the world, this Lyme disease is present. I told you that in some Asian countries the insects are used as food. There is a strong super food trend as regarding eating the insects, because there is a strong alternative protein that's green. This is how it's cited in the literature, because we are very rich in protein and good fats and other useful elements for our body from the perspective of human health. I mean to eat as much as possible products that are originated from the nature and of course from the forest. Another example, the bush meat or wild meat or wild game meat. We have to be also very carefully when we are eating game meat, because in most of the cases the animals are sources that can cause several infection diseases like tuberculosis, leprosis, cholera, and a lot of them. But we have to know that the game meat is very rich in some vitamins like A, D, some vitamins from the B complex, and also in omega-3, omega-6, calcium, potassium, magnesium, and other important elements for humans. And perhaps the most important thing is that the game meat is not treated with antibiotics and growth hormones like the one that we are buying usually from the market. Let's not forget the snakes, Vipera verus, perhaps the most common Vipera species. Are there other species? Another example from India, where the elephant-human conflicts are quite common. So every year India is reporting 400 people deaths and 100 elephant deaths due to the, let's say, conflict between these two species. And by coming back in our country, my country in Romania, the most, let's say, significant conflict nowadays is between the brown bear and the humans. Is a in my opinion, is due to the modification of the legislation 5 years ago, because nowadays we are speaking of a large population of brown bear in Romania, perhaps 6 to 8 thousand individuals that are located mainly in the center and northern part of the country along the Carpathian Mountains, but very present in the humans' gardens as well. Okay, I spoke about natural forest, but it's good to mention that also human-made forest or planted forest are very important from a perspective of human health and well-being. And I will give you a short example from Mushan, which is in Bolj country in the southwestern part of Bolj, where there is the phenomenon of desertification. In those countries, there are about 100,000 hectares that looks like this. So lands that were covered with forest 200-300 years ago, that was deforested, used as agriculture, and now due to the political and administrative features, most of them are not unmanaged and looking like this. And I'll give you a short example from a planting campaign 10 years ago. This is how it looks 2 years ago. So trees, black locust trees, were 8, 9, 10 meters in height. So their increment is a good one on these sandy soils. So an example with a lot of ecological, let's say, achievements, and all of them are translated to human health. Because in this region, we are recording also the so-called flying scents. And by doing this, by planting, and we planted in that region in the last 15 years around 6,000 hectares. And another, let's say, services provided by the forest, managing the temperature, limiting, decreasing the temperature. This is an example from last summer. As you can see, the temperature at 1 meter high was almost 40 degrees. The one at the ground level was 27 degrees. And in the same day, in the same hour, with two other thermometers located outside the forest, you see the temperature at ground level is 55 degrees, but it wasn't the warmest day from last summer, because the temperature at ground level could reach almost 70 degrees, which is not healthy even for humans. As a brief, let's say, or to brief the main idea, we are speaking nowadays by forest bathing. So spending time in forest will reduce, as I mentioned, the levels of anxiety, depression, anger, confusion, and also improve the cardiovascular functions, lowering the heart rate and diastolic blood pressure. And some words about the urban trees and green species. Many interesting figures are to be found in this recently published paper, according to which in 2018, 55% of humans were living in urban areas, but it's predicted that by 2050, 68% of humans will be living in urban areas. So the urban trees and the green spaces will gain more attention and more importance. So, for example, another two, let's say, important data: 90% of the world population lives in places where the air pollution is very high, exceeds the World Health Organization limits, and according to the same organization, around 7 million people are dying every year due to air pollution. So now this is a very important issue, and I'm quite sure that it will be more important in the following years. As regards the negative effects of the trees on human health, the negative effects, so we are speaking about the pollen, that we are speaking about the allergens, also the insects that are hosted by the trees, and the mechanical defeats that are producing several hazards. So as when we are speaking about the flowering, it is a major spring problem when the pollen is flying, is crossing several distances. A lot of body literature in this respect as well. So these are the main species that are releasing the allergens, all the rash, aspen, beech, and so on. But the trees are also the host to undesirable insects, like the case of Retuca ciliata, as far as I know, was introduced in our country also around 10 years ago. But it's important to mention also the mechanical defeats that are producing hazards, so the human health is under pressure, let's say. But we, with the proper management, we can monitor the health of the trees in order to propagate the human health. And another concept that was introduced 5 decades ago in Japan, with more than 2,000 urban tiny forests created. It is also present in Europe, across Europe. We introduced it also in Romania, starting from this year, because this urban tiny forest presents several benefits: physical and mental well-being, improving air quality, and so on, all of them being very connected with human health. Let's not forget the green roofs. This is a photo from Singapore, but in across European countries started to be quite common. Let's bring the forest into the cities. So let's plan from the beginning, the starting of building in the cities, to have them also green. And as regards one health, let's not forget, like Professor Michel mentioned, there should be a strong relationship between experts from different fields, because the problem is so complex. And my key messages or takeaway messages: let's not forget that the forest provides several products and services. Not all of them are free, but forest bathing is free. Let's choose the proper shrub or tree species for urban green planning, ask the experts from different fields, and let's try to have a specific urban tree management in every locality. So this is all from my part, and I thank you for your attention.